Asian. And so this topic is something very, very important in our daily lives. Because if you understand the reality of the patient, you know what really patient means. And here Shantideva is not talking about something ordinary patient, you know. So he's talking about transcendental patient. So transcendental patient is something, you know, very difficult to fit ordinary people's mind. It's beyond ordinary, something. It is something beyond, how can I say, like samsara mind. So transcendental patient is something, you know. It does not mean you are drawing from the difficulties and the hard situation. So here, transcendental patience means kind of like your inner strength or your inner courages. And you're looking from the two sides. One side you're looking from your goal, and the other side you're not losing your inner strength and courages. So this kind of patience is what Shantideva was talking about, transcendental patience. So it is something not drawing from difficult situations, and you're looking from one side, your goal, and other side you're not losing your courages. Means you are looking all this negative attitude from the positive side. It means your goal. So as I mentioned before, you have goal and courages. So your goal from the Buddhist perspective, your goal is to achieve enlightenment. And in order to achieve enlightenment, you need inner strength and courages. So you're not losing this true point and making all any negative attitude to the positive way, looking from the positive way. So it means that you are looking, you know, problem with the deeper causes and condition, and not looking from the temporary cause by other people, you know. Generally speaking, when somebody, you know, hurt you or you dislike your people, says, my enemy, and then enemy retaliate. So when you are encountered with the difficult situations, so you're looking from the deeper causes and condition, rather than looking from the temporary causes and condition created by other people. So when you are looking, when we look the problem from the deeper causes and condition, so this is what we are talking about here, transcendental patient. We are not drawing our mind from the difficult situations. Instead, we are making this difficult into the positive way, you know, because you have goal, like your goal, you're looking 2 points. So one is your goal, which is enlightenment, and one is not looking your inner strength and courages. With the combination of these 2 points, it is possible we will be able to, you know, change all this negative attitude, looking all this negative attitude to the positive way. So here, first, very important, in order to strengthen, you know. So Shantideva said, we are talking about samsara nature, you know. So as long as we are in the samsara, you know, so we cannot expect there's no problem, there's no trouble. There's always something there, you know. Some people dislike you, some people make you trouble. This is the this is what we are talking about, nature of samsara. So as long as we remain in the nature of samsara, we cannot expect there's no troublemaker, there's no somebody dislike you, always there, you know, because this is the nature of samsara. So however, you know, so as long as we remain in the samsara nature, you know, and we cannot expect these kind of things. So what we should do is, we have to look from the positive way to solve this problem. It means looking from the deeper causes and condition of the problem, and not looking at temporary causes, which is created by other people. Then it is possible we will be able to strengthen our transcendental patience. So here, when we talk about the you know, strengthen your mind and courages, because from a Buddhist perspective, you know, we everybody have this nature of mind, you know. This everybody have this innate nature of mind, you know, which is unborn, which is unceasing, you know. Everybody have this innate transcendental nature of the mind, which is unborn, which is unceasing. And so we cannot formulate this innate nature of mind is existing this way. Neither we cannot formulate this innate nature of mind does not exist this way. Very, very difficult to describe. Yet, on the basis of this innate nature of the mind, all the samsara, you know, illusions, and nirvana, everything appears because of this innate nature of the mind, which is unborn, which is unceasing. We cannot formulate existing this way, nor we cannot express not existing this way. Very difficult to express, but yet everything what we do is on the basis of this natural state of mind. So when we are able to look our problem from the deeper causes and conditions, we will be able to liberate all these thought, emotions, and conceptual mind in self-liberating mind, which means what from the remember that when we talk about nature of the mind, you know, this innate nature of mind, we cannot express, you know, this mind is coming, remaining, and dissolving, you know. When we're talking about coming, remaining, for example, a thought coming, remaining, and dissolving, we are not talking about this mind. Your thought coming, your thought remain, your thought cease in our daily life, you know. This is what we are talking about, very gross level, you know. Our gross conceptual mind, emotions, they are coming, they remain and dissolve. So they're coming, remaining, dissolve. But when we talk about this innate nature of mind, we cannot speak something like this. This mind coming, remaining, and departing. We cannot express something like that. So that means when we look, as Shantideva said, if we remain in the samsara, you know, so what we have to do is, so react, retaliate. So this is what we are talking about, samsara nature. So in order to dispel this kind of thought and emotions, we need to develop this transcendental patience, which is something that we're talking about. This text is very, very important. So here, first I want to read the thing here. 42, I think, 42. Previously, I must have caused similar harm to other sentient beings. Therefore, it is right for this harm to be returned to me. So who caused injury to others? So that is the... Now we are talking about this, to control this anger and this hatred is not easy. So what we have to do is, first we have to do initial stage, we have to do the analytical meditation. So meditation. So number one, first, when something like this happened, so we analyze of the basis of the anger, we analyze. So you're looking for a deeper cause and condition, not looking temporary cause and condition. So when we analyze the basis of the anger, so we will realize anger is unjustified. Now, this made 2 points, right? Analyzing the cause of harm and where the fault lies. And number two is analyzing your commitment. This made 2 points. So now, analyzing the cause of harm and where the fault lies. Here, Shantideva said, we talk about his weapon and my body, both the cause of suffering. He brought the weapon and I brought the body, so at which I should be angry. So this is something like that. We have this body, which is samsara nature, which is nature of pain and suffering. So, for example, like if you have very, Shantideva said, if you have big wound, right, and you are going into the crowd where there are many people, and people pushing everywhere here and pumping, causing you more pain. So you have kind of like big wound and you are going to the where there are many people gathering, pushing here and bumping each other, will cause you more pain. On the other hand, you know, there are many people running everywhere, you know, carelessly. On the other hand, there are many people running carelessly. So there's two, right? One, you have big wound and you are going into this big gathering and then pushing and popping causes you more pain. So whom to blame, you know? You shouldn't go there, you know, gathering. On the other hand, people are running carelessly, and if you go there, you know, who should you blame, you know? People are running everywhere carelessly. You have big wound, and if you are going there, you know, then this will go through more pain. Right? So here point is, Shantideva was talking about this you know, our human body, you know, is like a abscess, you know. Naturally painful, you cannot bear touch. But look, this birth blind by attachment, and so at which should I be angry, you know? So this is the what we are talking about. So generally speaking, when somebody dislike you, like somebody dislike you, and somebody make you trouble, right? And then we designate it enemy, right? Like, so we say he or she is my enemy. So when person let me read this one, Shantideva. Out of ignorance some cause other harm. Out of ignorance other get angry in response. Which of this is the acting faultlessly? Which of this is acting incorrectly? So because somebody dislike you, somebody cause you problem, we designate enemy, you know. So this enemy is acting due to ignorance, because not understanding that not understanding about karma, you know, karma. So if something do bad, the result will be pain and suffering. So due to ignorance, not understanding the consequences of the good karma and bad karma. So if somebody retaliate, if that person is not ignorant, then he or she will not retaliate, because understanding consequences of the karma. Due to ignorance, then people, when some people hurt you, then retaliate, right? So retaliate, then you destroy the cause of happiness. You naturally want happiness, but ignorance destroy this happiness. This is what ignorance means, you know. People who cause, and other people, you know, also due to ignorance, you know, somebody hurt you, then you retaliate back. So other person also due to ignorance, retaliate. So both are acting due to ignorance. So, but both person, you know, naturally desire happiness and do not want any pain, suffering. But due to not understanding about the, you know, the actions result, and then cause more pain. So therefore, this is Shantideva talking about when something like this happened, we should analyze this. We should analyze what is the deeper cause of pain and suffering. So deeper cause of pain and suffering is ignorance, not person. Person is just temporary. If you understand the deeper cause and pain of suffering, which cause is ignorance, then you will not retaliate. You will try to solve this problem with positive way. Positive way means try to solve this problem, looking from 2 points. You know, everything changed, right? Changing. Change the physical, change the speech, change your actions. These are due to not understanding deeper cause. Anger, deeper cause of anger is ignorance. So this is Shantideva. Next is both the weapon and my body are the cause of my suffering. Since the other gave me life to the weapon and I to the body, with whom I should be angry. So when somebody, you know, when we are not looking from the deeper causes and condition, we are just looking from a temporary, you know, cause and condition, then we think all faults are created by other. And you think I am faultless. All this problem is created by an external object. So when you think something, all this, you know, is created by the other object, then very difficult to solve the problem, you know, because you believe you are faultless and are the 100% fault, and there's no space you can change this kind of mental attitude. So that means when you encounter with this difficulty problem, so if you think all this coming from the deeper causes and condition which is lying within, inside our mind, you know, then there is space we can solve the problem, or we can minimize the problem, we can reduce the problem. I mean, if your anger is very strong, you will cut anger, minimize the anger. You know, you can cut that, make anger, you know, lighter, you know, so because you are doing analytical meditation. And so here, the next slide that was said, if in blind attachment I cling to the suffering excess of human form which cannot bear to be touched, with whom I should be angry when he is hurt. It is the fault of the childish that they are hurt, for although they do not wish to suffer, they are greatly attached to its causes. So why should they be angry with others? Just like the guidance of hands and the forces of the resolve sharp is. So is this suffering produced by my action, which with whom therefore should I be angry? Having been instigated by my own action, those who cause me harm come into being. If by these actions they should fall into hell, surely isn't it I who am destroying them? So this is what we are. So this is what we are talking about. So all this. Emotions are temporary, right? They are gross and temporary. Anger appears, remains, and goes. So that indicates this is gross mind. From the subtle mind, we cannot explain something like that. So something is coming, we will remain and departure, right? But what happened is, Shantideva said, when anger arises, it remains, it departs, it dissolves, but seed will remain for many long time, just like habituation, imprint, So that seed will carry all the time. So if you angry, you know, for example, like one day, if you angry 3 times, you plant 3 seeds of the anger. So that seed is man cause anger to arise tomorrow or day after tomorrow. So this is very important when you encounter with the, you know, some difficulties, anger arise, and then we should apply, you know, Dharma teachings, Dharma teaching. Dharma, you know, is the remedy, not only for temporary happiness, but it is a remedy of ultimate our happiness. So when we talk about Dharma, you know, we are talking about 2 types of individual person, you know, practice and realization. 2 types of Dharma, you know. Vasubandhu said in the Treasure of Knowledge, you know. The holy Dharma is 2 things, scripture and realization. Holding and spreading the teaching are the 2 great practices. So we can do this right. So holding scripture or the... So holding scripture means scripture, so you have to first study the Dharma, you know, hearing. But hearing, study the Dharma, so understand the Dharma. So for example, like if you study about patient, so you are studying about the, you know, it is transcendental patient, means you are studying about advantages of practicing patient and disadvantage of, you know, not practicing patient, and disadvantage of, you know, anger and hatred. So patient and it is the Dharma needed to dispel the hatred. So these 2 cannot go together, right? One opposes each other. If you are practicing patient, oppose more and more anger and hatred. If your hatred and anger increasing, then hatred and anger opposing patient, so losing your patient. So these 2 mind, right? Anger mind, patient mind, cannot go together. One oppose each other, like enemy, enemy. So when you have enemy, like, for example, like external enemy, what you should do, you know, in order to protect from your enemy, you do lots of things, right? Be aware where your enemy is coming, and if you have enemy, you will be very cautious about your enemy. What should I do? You know, when enemy comes, what should I do? You know, when enemy, you know, chase, where should I run away? You're thinking all this in your mind. When enemy comes, right? So your mind become more skillful, oh, do this, something like that. So similarly, you know, we are talking about internal enemy. You know. Internal enemy is not like external enemy. Internal enemy cannot see, but very powerful, right? You know, internal enemy, very powerful and very difficult to defeat internal enemy, because we need lots of meditation, you know, analyzing the problems and looking from the 2 points as I mentioned before, you know, one side about losing your strength and keep your encounter with difficulty, you know, we lose our self-awareness. So this is very dangerous. Who knows that? Nobody wants this kind of, you know, low self-esteem. You know. So when you look, 2 points will help you to, you know, bring up your self-awareness. It will strengthen your determination to fight, to defeat this either enemy. So in order to do this, then we have to scripture as we are studying two types of scripture, right? Individual person, you know, study, thinking, meditation, and then you can spread this to other people, you know, share your experience, share your teaching to other people. Then you are holding the Dharma, you know, two important scripture and realization. So you first study, then thinking, then meditation. You will share this with other people. Then you are holding the Dharma in the realization. So my point is, so when we talk about here, as I mentioned before, when we study, they were not talking about the ordinary patient. So it means in difficult situation, you are not driving your mind. When we look problem from the artificial cause and condition, very easy to lose our mind. But when we are looking from the deeper causes and condition, and then it's not difficult to lose our mind. Instead, you know, strengthen your mind like this. So that means so transcendental patience, it really means not drawing your mind when you are in a difficult situation. It means looking problem with the deeper causes and condition and transform that problem into the positive way. So that is the definition of the transcendental patient. Thank you. Any questions?
Geshe, does transcendental patience also involve patience with realization during your study and during your journey sort of thing? Is that important as well?
Yeah, definitely.
And how would you relate that the patient dealing with people? Are you better off applying antidotes or explaining people the baselessness of the action in the first place and the baselessness of the situation?
Yeah, but this is gradual, you know, so it's not like slowly. Antidote is you know, the different types of antidote, right? So this is like, I may give you an example of like, if you are practicing generosity, right? First you give small things, like food or whatever, you know. Then more familiar, you know, give some money. Like that, gradual, like, one step by step. So similar, patient also like that, right? So have to be, we cannot expect very quick result of this transcendental patient, right? But it is gradual, you know. When you are associating with the people, there are plenty of opportunity, you know. And during that period, then you have to use the Dharma attitude. And also very important to speak to the appropriate people. You can't speak. You have to check the object, you know. And it's gradual, slowly. Yeah. Thank you.